How much VRAM does Star Citizen currently use? What should you be looking for in a graphics card? These are the questions that we are looking at today. I've done some testing in and around the standard system, so let's just get straight into it. First up, we just need to talk about how we're going to record the amount of memory being used by the GPU. You've got two options, really. You've got in-game, which is shown on the right there, and then you've also got overlays. So this is Reverb Tuner, part of Afterburner. And you could also use things like GPU Z, or you could even use Windows itself to see what's going on. What we've got to be wary of is that often these programs will record what the GPU is asking for rather than what it's used, what it's actually using. So they'll look for allocated. The number on the left really is probably likely to be the allocated memory, what the GPU is requesting or what the game is requesting, rather than actually what it's using. So you'll see a lot, you'll have seen maybe some things about games going really high, using up to 10 gigabytes on the 3080 from Nvidia. And a lot of that, I think, is not quite accurate, in that people are just seeing what their overlays are displaying, and that's not really what the game is actually using. So in these tests here, I'm going to use the in-game display info 3 that I'm using here, which you can use to kind of get your frames per second and a load of other stats up. And I think that's much more likely to be an accurate total of what the game is actually using. So we're going to be using that. And as you see, there is quite a significant difference between display info and in the CryEngine in the Lumberyard and what Afterburner is showing us on the left there. So yeah, we're going to go with that. Next up, just want to talk about what resolution I'm testing this at. I'm going to test at 1080p because most people, when they're running into bottlenecks in terms of running out of GPU memory, are going to be on lower end cards, and they're not going to be targeting 1440p or 4K, definitely not 4K. 4K obviously pushes your utilization of memory higher, the textures and everything like that. It uses up more VRAM, but as you see here in this case, the difference between 1080p and 1440p at least is about 300 megabytes of memory. So it's not that different. But as I say, I don't think most people who are... Let's put it like this. If you're looking at 4K, you're probably going to have a card that's significantly quicker and therefore will have a large chunk of VRAM. Okay, so the way I'm going to do this, I'm going to let the footage run in the background. You'll see the amount. But the general gist is that if you are running around the standard system in 1080p at 1080p resolution, you're going to just stay just under probably about the 6 gigabyte mark in terms of VRAM reported by CryEngine / Lumberyard. That is the gist of this. I've also done most of my gaming really in 1440p, and really what happens there is you just jump up to about just a bit over 6 in my experience. I've not spent a lot of time looking at that, but when I've played and had it on and just scanned it, I haven't seen anything higher than that. So that then tells us vaguely what we're looking at in terms of, again, maybe minimum spec if you're looking at 1080p. We know that the minimum spec for this game really is, well, if you watch my previous videos, you'll know that CIG say on one part of their website that it's 3 gigabytes, and then they heavily imply that it's actually 4 gigabytes in another place. We've tested some 4 gigabyte cards. I don't think the bottleneck of the not having enough memory was the issue. Those cards just aren't quick enough, but the game will run fine with 4 gigs of GPU memory. So that's not the issue. The thing that you're probably having to work out here is if you're buying a new card or trying to buy a new card, I guess nobody can actually get hold of any of them. You're looking at the Nvidia lineup, and you're also looking at the AMD lineup, and they're quite radically different in terms of what they're doing with GPU RAM. If you look at the Nvidia lineup, you've got this bizarre situation where the 3090 obviously has got tons, 24 gigs. That isn't for gaming. Don't get this confused. The 3090 is not really a gaming card. That 24 gigabytes of memory is complete craziness for gaming. You're not going to use that. 3080 has got 10 gigabytes, actually less than the 2080 Ti that has got 11. Again, although the AMD will show you in a minute, will try and convince us that that might be a problem. I don't really think realistically that is going to be a problem in any way. So that's interesting. And then the 3070 has got 8 gigs, the 3060 Ti has got 8 gigs, and then bizarrely, the 3060 has 12 gigs. What's gone on there? Really, it's just a response from Nvidia to AMD. They have whacked 16 gig on everything, which makes buyers look at the Nvidia lineup and say, oh, wow.
what's going on here. And also then you've got this this lovely piece of marketing here from AMD saying, oh yeah, no, don't worry, you do need 16 gigs in these games at 4K, you will need 16 gigs, which again, whether that's actually what the game is using, or whether that is marketing malarkey, or I think in reality all of those games that at 4K will run fine with a lot less memory than that. Even if often what happening is the GPU has memory, therefore it will load some of these things, the textures in. Like, why would you not? The game engine will just say, okay, well, you've got the space, you might as well have them. Doesn't necessarily mean they're being used at that time. It really is a bit of a marketing thing. Clever by AMD to just, I mean, the thing with, if you go AMD on this generation, you're not worrying about VRAM at all. You've just got absolutely loads, way more than you can use in most cases, and overkill really. But then if you flip back to AMD, to Nvidia, they've basically, this 3060 came out, I think it was the last of these cards to come out, and they've had to respond to the 16 gig on everything. And I think I was watching a video the other day that was basically saying that with the 3060, they had a choice because of the way the graphics card is made, and without getting too technical, the bus size of the memory. It was either going to be 6 gigs or it was going to be 12, and I think they basically said, well, 6 gigs maybe is not going to look great compared to the 16 gigs that come on AMD. Or even, we'll see, AMD haven't really released any cards in this range yet, but we can assume that they're going to have more than 6 gigs of memory for sure. This lineup now looks all wrong. So why has this 3060 got more memory than the top end 3080? But really, let's put it like this. The 3060 Ti is a better card than the 3060s quite significantly. It will be too slow as a card before it runs out of GPU memory, in my opinion. I don't think the 3060 is a better buy because it's got 4 gig more of VRAM. That is just not how it works. It's a slower card, and 4 or 5 years down the line, it will be, the issue won't be that it's not got enough memory. The issue will be that it's too slow to run new games. Maybe that's all theoretical. The thing is, all these new cards are so quick that at 1080p and likely at 1440p with some of these, they will be running these kind of newer games for a long time. The actual look at the market now and looking at what the different brands are using we were in a strange place where AMD are just slapping on masses of VRAM and Nvidia are trying to work out cost versus marketing versus all of it. So yeah, back to actual Star Citizen. We are obviously in an alpha. We're not in a position where this is the final specs of the game. We see they've done a decent job of managing the memory at the moment by looks things in the engine. It's not, yeah, it's the VRAM usage that we're seeing now is nothing particularly scary or to be worried about for Star Citizen itself. Obviously nobody's just playing Star Citizen, but if we just isolate Star Citizen and talk about that, really, if you had a graphics card, it's tricky. If you're looking to buy one versus if you've got one. If you've got one now that has 4 gigabytes of memory in the GPU, you shouldn't upgrade because of VRAM at all. The only reason you'll be wanting to upgrade that card probably is because it just isn't quick enough as a card anyway. If you're looking to buy one, you've got to say that you could obviously buy a 6 gigabyte graphics card, something like the 1060, not that quick anyway, or maybe even the 980 Ti, which I think has got 6 gigabytes of memory, but that's probably too, bordering on the too slow now. You're probably targeting 8 gigs of memory. That's probably what you're looking to buy. And there's a load of cards out there with that. And the short of this is, you shouldn't worry too much about VRAM for Star Citizen. If you've got enough, if you've got 4, 6, 8, at the moment it will run fine. This will probably change as the game goes forward. We keep talking about Vulkan coming at some point and whether that will change things. It won't necessarily change the amount that the engine uses up front, I don't think, but it may mean that they change how they build the game going forward. So we may see an increase, but as I always say, Star Citizen is not in a place where you should be building your system around it completely anyway. It's yeah, it's really early on still in the project, which I know sounds ridiculous. It's many years into it, but we're not at the point where you could look at the system requirements now and get anything meaningful out of them. That we've looked at this before, they're wrong basically for a start. But from a VRAM point of view, there's nothing really here to worry about. It's more the case of if you've got enough and it will run, and there's nothing, it isn't taking crazy amounts to run the game. So there we go, there's some thoughts.
If you like this, I'd love a like. Subscribe if you like this more technical look at Star Citizen, and come and follow me on Twitch, where when I get to 100,000 Twitch followers, I'm going to get a tattoo of Chris Roberts' face on my foot. See you soon. Bye.